Hello friends, I am Sampada Kulkarni, welcomes you in my channel Tech Talks. Today, I am going to brief about heapifying, the concept used in Heap Sort. Before moving to heapify, you must know what is Heap Tree, because on the basis of Heap Tree only, we can continue with the concept of heapifying. For your reference, I am providing you a shortcut link in this right-up corner for this Heap Tree. This is nothing but the lecture series, video series for the Heap Sort, in which the first video is already released, and for this shortcut link I am providing in this right-up corner. This is the second video which will explain details about the concept of heapifying. So, before moving to heapify, let's know about what is Heap Sort. Heap Sort is nothing but a sorting technique where we can sort an array of the elements. To sort the array of the array elements, we can use the heaps. Heaps are nothing but a data structure where the elements are stored in a specific order or in a special order. What is that order or in which they can be arranged, that you will come to know in the video introduction of tree and its types. For that also I am providing a shortcut link in this right up corner, how to arrange that array elements to form a complete binary tree and as well as the heap tree. This is nothing but the sorting technique in which the comparisons are required. Always, whenever you are going to perform the sorting, comparison must be there, because without comparison we can't decide which one is the smallest, which one is the greatest, and we can't arrange them in a sorted manner. So this is nothing but the comparison based sorting technique which uses the binary heap data structures. So binary heap data structure is used in the Heap Sort. It is somehow similar to selection sort. If you want to know details about the selection sort, one video is already released on the selection sort. For that also I am providing a shortcut link over here in this right up corner. Now we'll see the working on heap data structures. Whenever we want to perform the operation like sorting with the help of heap sort, heap data structure we need to implement. For that implementation we need to take help of arrays and trees. These are two basic data structures. With the help of these two data structures we can construct the heap data structure which can be used for the sorting purpose. So if you want to know details about the arrays, that also available in my video sessions, for that also I am providing a shortcut link. As well as to know details about trees, basically the binary tree and the types of binary tree, mainly a complete binary tree, that also available in my previous video. So now whenever we want to perform the sorting with the help of heap data structure, we must know the concept of arrays as well as trees. And now heap sort works by visualizing the elements of array as a special kind of complete binary tree, as I explained just now. So with the help of this complete binary tree we can implement heap or heap tree. That is, that heap or heap tree is the main thing from which we are going to start the heap sort. Let's move to the next slide where I am going to explain you what is heap tree. Heap tree can be represented in these two ways, either max heap tree or a min heap tree. What are the details about max heap tree, min heap tree is already introduced in heap tree introduction wala video. So what is max heap? In short I am going to explain you. Max Heap, where always the parent node is having value greater than its children. Here you can see every parent node, that is 12, is having greater value than its children, 10 and 9. 10 is a parent node whose value is greater than its children, 5 and 6. Same way, 9 is having a single child and 9 is having value greater than its child, 1. So every parent is having the higher value, maximum value, greater value than that of children is nothing but the max heap. Other way round, in the opposite, mean heap, where the child are having greater value than that of the parent, or we can say that the parent is having lesser value or a smaller value than that of its children. So in this way, the mean heap can be constructed. How to construct max heap, mean heap, that I am going to cover up in the next slide, and that process is called as heapifying. So now let's move to the next slide. So now what are the steps for the construction of heap tree? Basically only the heap tree. I am not going to say like heap tree is max heap or main heap. Only a simple heap tree, that must be the complete binary tree. So for the construction of heap tree, the first step is to construct a complete binary tree from the array elements. So what are the steps we need to follow? That are already explained in the previous video. If you have not gone through that, you just pause this slide and you can go through how to construct a heap tree. One by one, we need to fill every level of the complete binary tree by inserting a one node one by one, starting from the root node. In the next level, we need to start from the left child of a root node and so on. So you can construct any n number of levels in this way to form a complete binary tree. This is nothing but a complete binary tree, not a heap tree. After construction of complete binary tree, the next or most important step is nothing but heapify the tree to form it as a heap tree. Okay, this is nothing but a constructed complete binary tree, is not a heap tree. But if we want to convert it into heap tree, we need to perform the heapify function on that complete binary tree. Then you will get the output as a heap tree, that will be either max heap tree or a mean heap tree. So now let's start with the heapifying. What is heapify? So heapify is nothing but the process of modifying complete binary tree to the heap tree. Okay, so now what we must have? We must have the complete binary tree with us. So array elements will be there on which you want to perform the sorting. That array elements you need to convert it into the complete binary tree. After that, you need to convert it into the heap tree. Here I have explained that the complete binary tree is with me. After performing or applying heapify, the resultant tree is nothing but the heap tree. That can be max heap tree or min heap tree. That will depend on which property we are going to use. If max heap is there, the parent node must be having the higher value than that of the children. And if min heap tree is there, the parent node will be having the less value than that of the children. That we need to manage. So, starting from a complete binary tree, we can modify it to become a max heap or min heap, just now I have explained, by applying the heapify on all the non-leaf elements of the heap. So now, how this heapifying is to be done, that I am going to explain in the next slide. So now, there are three different scenarios that we need to take care of while heapifying the binary, complete binary tree to max heap. Now here I am going to convert my complete binary tree to the max heap. So now very first thing, if my root is itself having greater or the larger value than that of the children, then there is no any need to do anything else, because already this tree is satisfying the property of max heap. So if the scenario 1 is there, that is parent is already largest than that of its children, then no need to perform any of the task. Keep this as it is. Now we'll move to the second scenario, where if, listen carefully, if root had larger element as a child and we need to swap to maintain the max heap property. Okay, here what we need to do, this root is not having the larger value. Here you can see child is larger than the parent. Child node is having larger value than that of the parent is not allowed in the max heap tree. So what we need to do, we need to swap both the elements. After swapping both the elements, 7 is going to become a parent node and 2 is going to become its child node. So now 7 is a parent which is larger than that of its children. So here we can see that, or we can say that, this is the tree who is satisfying the max heap property, and that's why this is nothing but the max heap tree. And move to the last scenario, if more than one level is there. So in this case, what we need to do, suppose the top element is not a max heap, but all the subtrees are in the max heap, or they are satisfying the max heap property. So let's see, this is a subtree where 10 is a parent node and 5, 6 are the children node. So 10 is greater than 5, 6, so it is satisfying the max heap property. Second subtree is 9 is a parent node, 1 is a leaf node or a child node, where 9 is greater than 1, it also satisfies the max heap property. But here you can see that 2 is a parent node for the nodes 10 and 9, children 10 and 9, where 2 is not greater than its children. So we need to perform the Heapify. We need to apply the Heapify to convert this tree into the max heap tree. What to do? Now let's see what we can do to perform the task. Here the original tree is there. We need to find out among its children which one is the greatest one. Among these 10 and 9, which one is the greatest one? So here we can see that 10 is the greatest one. So what we will do, first of all, we will swap both the nodes, that is 2 and 10. After that swapping, it will look like this. 10 is going to become a parent node, 2 is going to become its left child, and 9 is as it is. Now if we will see, this is the tree where 10 is greater than 2 and 9. We can see that, or we can say that, this is the max heap tree. Let's move to the next level. For this next level, 2 is a parent node and its children nodes are 5 and 6. Is this subtree satisfies the max heap property? No, it doesn't satisfy the max heap property. What we can do? We need to again apply the Heapify concept or a process where among its children nodes, I need to find out which one is the greatest one. 5 or 6? Yes, correct. 6 is the greatest node. So what I need to do? 6 I need to swap with 2. So after swapping, let's move 6 as a parent node, 2 as a child node. And now here you can see that this is the tree who satisfies the max heap property. So in this way, I have converted this tree into the max heap tree. This was only the complete binary tree, but now this is also a complete binary tree, but satisfies the max heap property. So that's why I am going to use the term as this is my max heap tree. So in this way, I can apply the Heapify function to convert from the complete binary tree to the max heap or a min heap tree. So in this way, we can apply the Heapify function to any another complete binary tree to construct it as the max heap tree or a min heap tree. So thank you dear friends for listening and watching my video. Please do not forget to give the comment. If you like the content and the video, please like my video. Please subscribe my channel Tech Talks and share all the videos with your friends. Keep this bell ringing, because ringing bell will give you the notification about my channel, about the new videos of my channel. Here I am providing you the subscription link. Please do subscribe my channel. Along with this, I am providing you some of the useful video links. For this video series lecture, I am providing you the next video about how to perform sorting with the help of Heapify operation, or after performing Heapify operation, we are having the heap tree. After that, how to perform sorting. For that, I am providing you a shortcut link over here. Thank you.